details in the artist studio.
He was trained in classical painting, but has merged with the computer digital age beautifully. We're in the artist studio today with Ignatius Widyaprajna.
Yes.
Ignatius, thank you so much for coming and for letting us come here. And you have so many interests, it's going to be hard to narrow down your very many talents. You started out actually as a jewelry artist, tell
yes.
us.
Yes,
I'm from Indonesia.
Yes, I'm from Indonesia. My grandfather was a goldsmith, a master goldsmith. And so when I came to the U.S., I studied at the University of El Paso. I moved to Texas and El Paso in the jewelry program. And that's when I got my master's, too, from Salina University. And then in 85, Drake hired me as the jewelers at the Drake. In here.
And then your path took you into painting? And
yes. Well, I was trained as a painter before in the classical painting, on a traditional painting. And then I came to here, and then I paint a little bit, but concentrate more in jewelry. And then my ideas getting bigger, jewelry just can't take it anymore. So I started painting again, and probably the last 20 years I've been painting exclusively.
And now you have merged in the digital age.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Oh yes, and I'm very interested in digital, and because of the possibilities, it's far what traditional painting can do. I mean, and also it's a lot faster in terms of compositions and the possibility of details and so forth. So I started working digitally, and the process that I work right now, and I took all the photographs myself from my traveling to Cambodia, Nepal, Tibet, and then I photo collage them digitally, all of them, and then once I'm happy with all the collage in black and white, I print them on canvas, about 60 by 40 inches canvas, and then I paint on top of them, using traditional painting technique, like glazing techniques, and the materials I use are acrylic, and because they dry a lot faster and easier to manipulate.
What catches your eye? I mean, as you say, a collage, what kind of messages are within your paintings? Do you have themes?
Yes, actually, it's very interesting that a lot of the theme that I've been fascinated for the longest time, and not until recently that I realized there's a consistency, is that I'm fascinated with the ideas of duality, what I call the divine paradox. I did research a lot on the study of comparative religions as well as all the symbols, and discovered that a lot of the divine presence are duality of good and evil at the same time. It's a very, very interesting, you know, like in the Old Testament, you know, God can be really, really kind, but the same time can be really, really cruel at the same time, you know. Mm-hmm. So it's a very interesting dichotomy, all the, you know, like Shiva, it's the same way, mm-hmm. you know. So a lot of the themes based on that, and also how, and also what fascinates is the power of nature with men, and the relationship between nature and men, you know, and we often think in the modern time man can conquer nature, but that's impossible. Even you see all the structure in Cambodia, you realize nature will take over your life pretty quickly.
Yeah, yeah. And you do travel quite a bit, so this is where you get your ideas.
Yes.
The right. Nature, the part of it. What's next for you? Sculpting? I mean, you've got so many interests.
No, I think I'm going to stick with painting for now, because the new directions still has a lot mm-hmm. to do, and the technique, actually the combination between digital and traditional media is really exciting to me.
It can take you so many different places.
Yes, right. And I dabble a little bit in video too, but mm-hmm. I haven't really pushed it very far. But the technology is very interesting.
Okay. Well, Ignatius, thank you very much for letting us come kind of get a glimpse of how you put this all together on canvas. We appreciate it very
thank
much.
Thank you.
For KCCI, I'm Molly Cooney in the Artist Studio.
You can see more of his works at an upcoming exhibit at Moberg Gallery at 2921 Ingersoll Avenue in Des Moines. Opening reception Friday, February 3rd from 5 until 8. The exhibit runs through March 17th. For more information, go to www.moberg.com.